Back here on the Central Coast, we're now less than 2 weeks away from the elections in Carmel, and one candidate for mayor seems to be breaking the mold. He doesn't want to be called a politician. He's pitching a reality show around his family, and his voting record is in question. We introduced you to him last week. He's Richard Pepe. Well, now I sat down with him again to talk about the video and his voting.
Well, my friends are always breaking my chops because East Coast Pepe, that's what they know me as. Hey, Pepe. Hey, Pep. Out here, now I'm Pepe.
It's the YouTube video seen and heard around Carmel.
It's Jersey Boy, fish out of water. I parlayed a donut into a family dynasty.
The trailer for a reality TV show called Piece of Cake features a family running businesses in Carmel and all the glitz and drama that comes with the lifestyle. And the narrator, a fast-talking, self-proclaimed Jersey Boy, is none other than Carmel's own candidate for mayor, Richard Pepe.
Oh, I just think it's fun and classy and hysterical, really.
But the clip seems to be garnering some mixed reviews among Carmelites.
It seems entertaining, I guess. I don't know. I guess if it brings people to Carmel, kind of like Clint did back in the day. But I don't know if he's more into it for being a mayor or for being popular.
I think it's wonderful that we have this opportunity to express ourselves this way.
I didn't particularly like it, and I don't like him. I think that he has a poor way of expressing himself.
It'd be wonderful. It would put us on the map. Again.
We sat down and watched the video with Pepe himself, and he gladly watched with a smile.
We're trying to add some celebrity back to Carmel, and truth be told, I mean, we were hired on as actors in this show from these producers, LA producers.
Pepe explained to us the show is scripted, and he knows there are some lines some people aren't too thrilled about.
The only thing that was negative, when we had a couple of voiceovers, don't forget, this was all staged. Everything is staged in the entire thing. And then we had a couple of voiceovers where I was asked to say a couple of lines that maybe were a little bit, you know, maybe unfortunate.
Are you referring to the police incident?
Yes.
The police incident appears towards the end of the trailer. Here it is. Judge for yourself.
If you're giving my Ferrari a ticket for crossing the line, I'm going to be running for mayor and you'll be scrubbing floors.
For those who don't think a mayoral candidate should be in a show like this, regardless of if it's scripted or not, Pepe doesn't agree, but says it won't be an issue. If the show does get picked up, he probably won't be as visible.
Well, the networks are looking at it right now, and they want to script it more about my sons. If you saw the video and watched it closely, it really is going to be more about the sons and their involvement. And they want to actually pit them against each other and make it look like it's a competition between the two sons.
Aside from the reality show, there's a buzz around town that Pepe hasn't voted in 40 years. So we asked him straight out.
When was the last time that you voted in Carmel?
Well, I haven't voted in the last three elections in Carmel, for sure. But we lived in outside the city limits for about the last 12 years also. So it really wasn't since the 90s that I voted.
Were you registered to vote in Monterey County?
Yes.
Or you weren't?
Yes.
Okay, because we called yesterday, and they said you just registered in 2011.
Well, I called also, and I've fallen off the voter registration list.
Did they say how that happened, or?
Well, because I had moved, and I didn't re-register.
After you moved,
right.
Even within, because you moved from one town to another, or?
Right.
Pepe says regardless of whether or not he's voted, he knows the issues and the city, and has the chops to make some real progress.
Well, I think my record stands for itself. We've been in business for over 30 years in town. We're major contributors to many local causes throughout the Monterey Peninsula. And I think we're known as being a pretty good guy.
And that's all this Jersey Boy has to say about that.
And voters head to the polls on April 10th.